If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification.
Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture of intermediate level maths, where we are solving JEE main questions. It is of trigonometry part 1. So in this lecture, we will be solving question number 1, 2, 3, 4. From question number 1 to question number 4. Okay, then let's try to solve these questions. Okay, so in question number 1, what they are asking, it is given sin square theta is equal to 4xy by x plus y whole square. It is true if and only. Now we know what is the value of sin square theta. Sin theta, your sin theta varies between minus 1 to 1. So your sin square theta, because it will be always positive, it will vary between 1 to 0. So this one we know. That means this one, 4xy by x plus y whole square, that should be less than 1. That's what we know. Okay. So if it is possible, and your x plus y whole square, if I take this one, I will be greater than 4xy. That is the idea. If you inverse it, then it will, this sign will change, and then 4xy will be on. I think you can do it. If you cross multiply it, x plus y whole square, because x plus y whole square is always positive, so x plus y whole square is greater than 4xy. So it will be x plus y whole square. Why I have done this cross multiplication? Because it is always positive, so you can multiply inequality by a positive number anytime if you know it is a positive number. So it is x minus y whole square is always greater than 0. Is it true always? Yes, it is always true, because x minus 1 something whole square is always greater than 0. This is true, that means this is also true. That means this is satisfying this one. Okay, that means x and y can take any value, any value. But so if you see option, x and y can take any value, but x plus y cannot be 0. If this is 0, then this thing becomes infinite, so which is meaningless. Sine output cannot go infinite. So x plus y cannot be equal to 0. This is the condition. Rest, it can do anything. You can put any value of x plus y, because it is satisfying that inequality. It is, it will be always less than your 1. But the problem will be, if it is equal to 0, then it will give rise to infinite, which is not possible in case of sin theta. Now in question number 2, what they are asking, your alpha beta such that your alpha is given a range between alpha minus beta is between pi to 3 pi, sin alpha plus beta, and they are asking cos alpha minus beta y. So obviously from seeing this, if you see all this, cos alpha plus beta, and you want to go for alpha minus beta by 2, then one formula it comes in your mind, which give you this minus this by 2, c plus d by 2, c minus d by 2, that is sin c plus sin d or cos c plus cos d. So if we apply this one here, what is this? This is sin c plus sin d. So what will be it is sin c plus sin d, 2 sin, if I apply here this first one. So 2 sin c plus sin c plus d by 2 and cos c minus d by 2. This is equal to minus 21 by 65. Similarly, if I do here cos c plus cos d, so it will be 2 cos c plus d by 2 into cos c minus d by 2 is equal to minus 27 by 65. Now if you see these two equations, there will be a temptation of dividing these two, because then cos cos get cancelled, but alpha minus beta will get cancelled, but we need alpha minus beta. So dividing these two will not be possible. So one more idea how to eliminate alpha, that means I have to eliminate alpha plus beta. One is sine, one is cos. So how to eliminate this? The best idea is sin square plus cos square is 1. Sin square alpha plus beta by 2, cos square alpha plus beta by 2 is equal to 1. So I will square both these and then I will add. So if we add and square, so it will be 4 sin square cos square, 4 cos square cos square. So this one, because cos square alpha minus beta you will take common, 4 also will take common. So what will you left with? It will be 4 cos square alpha minus beta by 2, and inside it will be sin square alpha plus beta by 2 plus cos square alpha plus beta by 2. What I have done, I have taken just square of this one, square of this one, then I have added these two. Squaring this, then you add. If you add 4 cos square you can take common, then here it will be left. And if you do it here, I am directly writing, you can easily do it, 1170 by 65 square, 21 square plus 27 square, you will find this one, check it out. So this is one. So from here you will get cos alpha minus beta by 2, you will have two value. If you divide it 4, then take root, so you will have plus minus 3 root 130, again I am directly writing, 3 plus minus 3 by 130. Now which one you should take value? Now for that, plus or minus, for that in the option you may find both are there. So where you will find this one, this is given. You see what is given, your alpha minus beta, alpha minus beta is lies between pi to 3 pi. So if you divide by 2, alpha minus beta by 2 will lie between pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. So what is the range? Pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. This is my pi by 2. This is my 3 pi by 2. That means here, this angle lies in these two quadrant. So in these two quadrant, what is the value of cos? It is always negative. So answer will be minus 3 by root 130. So this you have to be careful. For this, they will give some range of alpha or the angle. From here, you will find it is positive or negative. So this is your option A. Now question number 3, already we have solved, you can check it out, it is question number 2y 2 1. In advanced level of quadratic, that is in lecture 1, you will find it, quadratic equation lecture 1, in advanced you will find the same question I have solved, exactly the same one, so in 2y. So you can see the questions repeats from IIT entrance to JEE main, so the concept remains, concept every time remains, sometimes question also repeats, so the idea you have to remember, that's why. And you have to solve all these questions, then you will get some idea how to tackle the MCQs. Now here x is given and cos x plus sin x is also given. They are asking to find tan x. Now when you see this type of equations, this we will also discuss in when we will go for equations. This is all on this format, a sin x plus b cos x. So we will discuss this one in how to solve in trigonometry equation, that is part 2 of trigonometry. But here you see, because it is 1 1, so I think in class 10 also you have done, or no, class 10 you will not do. So in board exams also you can do this one, 1 by root 2 if I do, and 1 by root 2 here also. So what it will be, because it will be then cos pi by 4, you can write, it is sin pi by 4 you can, so it will be cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So it will be cos pi by 4 cos X, it will be sin pi by 4 sin X. Or you can write either way, you can go for cos A cos B, you can go for sin A sin B, whatever you prefer. You go either way, that will be okay. You can write it also sin pi by 4 because both are same. Then it will be sin A cos B plus cos A sin B, you will get sin A plus B. Whatever, if there is no harm, so 1 by 2 root 2. So if you do this one, you will get cos X minus pi by 4 because cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, cos A minus B is equal to 1 by 2 root 2. Now what they are asking? They are asking you to find tan. So if I go for this, now you can think of cos, this one is 1 by 2 root 2. So if you draw a triangle, and what will be tan x minus pi by 4, that's what I am thinking. And your x is between 0 to pi, that also you have to think. Okay, what is x minus pi by 4 then? X minus pi by 4 will lie between minus pi by 4 to pi minus pi by 4. That is 3 pi by 4. So what will be there in quadrant? Your x minus pi by 4, this angle lies between minus pi by 4 to 3 pi. It is pi minus pi by 4. That is 3 pi by 4 is here. That is 135 degrees. So your angle lies between here to here. So up to here, your tan can be positive also, negative also. So you have to be careful. So here cos is 2 root 2, then it is 1. Sorry. This is base by hypotenuse. This is 2 root 2. So what will be this one? This will be root 7. So this square minus this square. This is coming from under root 2 root 2 square minus 1 square. That is Pythagoras theorem. 8 minus 1, 7. So once you know this one, then you can write this one. What will be 10? Hide by base. So it can be plus minus root 7. You have to take care of both the sign, because here lots of plus minus are there. Any one can be the answer. Okay. Now if you know this one, so we'll try one by one. So you know this formula. 10a minus 10b is 10 pi by 4 is 1. 1 plus 10a 10b. So if I take plus 7, I can take one more and I can write it minus 7 also. So if it is, if I, same again, it is minus root 7. So from here you can do component and dividend, you can find what is 10x, or you can change the side, that also you can cross product and change sign. So if you do this one, you will get 10x here. I think you can do it. Take product, cross product, then, or you can take component or dividend, or whatever you do, you will find it is minus 4 plus root 7 by 3. And here it will be minus 4 minus root 7 by 3. You can do it. Cross product, they all take all 10x one side, then you calculate 10x, that's it. So okay, so if you do this one, so it is coming something of this fashion. So then you have to rationalize also. If you cross product in, then you have to take rationalize, then it will come. Or you can do directly one, I am showing component or dividend. This plus this, if you do 10x minus 1 plus 1 plus 10x, suppose if I am doing this, and then this plus this, then this minus this, suppose I am doing. This is the component and dividend. So here also this divided by 1. So you have to root 7 plus 1 by root 7 minus 1. You can do. If you are doing this one, then 1 will get cancelled, it will get 10x by, it will be minus 2. So 2 also get cancelled, it will be then root 7 plus 1 by root 7 minus 1, which implies your 10x will be equal to root 7 plus 1 divided by 1 minus root 7. So for rationalizing, you will multiply it by 1 plus root 7 in numerator denominator. So if you do this one, it will be 7 minus 1, that is 6 minus 6, and it is 7 plus 1, 8 plus 2 root 7. So if you divide it, it will be 4 plus divided by 2, 3 minus. That's what you are getting here. Same thing you do for this one also. This one I am not repeating. So ultimately you will get this and this one as an answer. So you see which one is given as an option. So option, only this one is given in the option. This is not in the option. Because here 10 can take both, so you have to go for both. You have to keep both the signs. You have to do separately. See, the answer may be, it will not be the answer there. In the option there, maybe they can give this one also. So whichever is given, that one will be the answer. Because here plus minus, it can be both. If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.